is the biggest ruminant vet congress that happens every other year. And so it is important for vet practitioners to be here because they can meet other vets coming from all over the world. They can also meet academics and they can update their knowledge about the ruminant medicine, surgery. And so it is a big fest of the ruminant family. We launched Q-Test almost 4 years ago at the end of 2020, and we have now sufficient data to draw some conclusions. The first one is that the global prevalence of the disease is 42%. It can differ slightly between countries, but it's always above 30%. The second finding is that the prevalence of Q fever is not significantly different between farms with major reproductive disorder like abortion, stillbirth, weak offspring of premature calving, and with farms with minor reproductive disorders like endometritis, retained fetal membrane, or subfertility. And the last finding, if we compare farms with reproductive disorders and farms selected randomly, we can say that the risk for a farm to be infected by Q fever is 3 times higher in farms experiencing reproductive disorders. We carried out 2 studies, one for dry off and one for the treatment of mild mastitis case. First, dry off. So using Velactis and abrupt dry off, we show that in Vietnam, the use of Velactis allows the gain of production of 49 kilograms for the 7 last days of lactation. If we transform this into money, we can say that the farmer gained 8.7 euros more using Velactis, and of course, it includes the cost of the product. In addition, of course, the farmers and the cow benefit the other advantages of Velactis, which is the reduced risk of milk leakage and consequently the reduced risk of urethral mammary infection, and also a better welfare because the pressure in the udder is lower and the cow is less in pain after drive. A second study aimed at assessing the interest of ketoprofen instead of anti-infective in the treatment of mild mastitis cases. We found that in 88% of the cases of mild mastitis, the cow did not need any anti-infective. This is of particular interest because it leads to a reduction use of anti-infective, which is more in accordance with the sustainable use of these molecules.